We have one hell of an episode for you guys with the latest news, an interview with Franco, and a new segment. So, let's go, guys! Alright, so the last few weeks have been full of some great music news, so let's start off with just that. The biggest piece of news that we're all excited about is the release of the new Urbandub album, Esoteric! Where pre-orders and reservations actually skyrocketed in iTunes Asia. Can you guys believe that? Isn't that awesome? That's very cool. And all 10 songs were produced and recorded right here at Tower. The album was released officially in stores at the last week of August. So if you guys don't have a copy yet, go out and grab your own now. While that's the news on the latest music, we also have some great news on our other releases. Recently, Tower of Doom tied up with Amplify.ph and released our entire catalog for free! Diba? Ang sarap pag libre. Pagkain, lalo na pag music. Now, this includes our old releases like Plane Divides the Sky, Out of Body Special, Imbuno Kudos, and much more. So swing by Amplify.ph today and see how you can download your favorite TOD hits for free. A lot of you guys may have first heard about Tower of Doom through Tower Sessions, but aside from the live performances, we also produce a fair amount of music videos. Now, over the past few months, we put out a few music videos that you all should check out. In July, we put together a music video for Kamikazee's The Mist. Now, the video was shot right here in the blue room, and it reached as high as number 3 on Mix. The Mist is from their latest album, Romantico, and you can check out the video right here. Also in July, we put out a brand new video for Jejaview. Now, the video is for their song Summer 2011, which was released on their debut album, People Are Watching. And it actually features some of the coolest people that you know, including probably your favorite host. So, if you guys are wondering who, just check it out right here. Earlier this year, we put out the latest Franco album, and we got a lot of requests from people who wanted to know more about the band. So we invited the guys of Franco here at the studio to, you know, just catch up with them. So check it out right here on this episode's Talk Back.
Me and Paulo, we've been in the band for the longest time, I think. Way back in 94.
We're old, man.
Playing for a really long time. 15 years, I think.
No.
19.
So yun pala. When we got together, wala pa, hindi pa na, wasn't even born yet, I think. Gives you the idea that we're really old, hence the white hair. With this lineup, si Papa Boards ng Kamikazee, he told me that he had somebody to play drums for us. We decided to tried this guy out. He was kind of nervous, but it's naman. Dave came in afterwards, recommendations then from friends then. So that's how this lineup came up. Ako, may telly, man. That was my first guitar, first paycheck, first job that I had in the States. First paycheck. The moment I got that paycheck, man, I already sold that telly. I bought that guitar in 1991. That's older than Victor, man.
Yeah, first real guitar, Fender Strat.
Oh, pero wala na yung ulo. Sarang sira na.
Hindi, okay pa siya. Di ba guys, music natin?
Ako wala eh. Kasi usually, every group that you wind up with, iba yung style. Pag ganun kasi pag bassist, kailangan palit ka na naman kasi hindi bagay din sa music. Pero I'm really glad with this one that I got. I'll be hanging on to this one for quite a while now.
Na yung snare na ginagamit ko pa rin hanggang ngayon, yung ginamit ni Chris Penny dito. Ayan. Tsaka siya rin yung first na sa really kong built-in na snare.
Ako? I left my family in the States, man.
Wow.
Just to be in this shit. Nah. That's
it.
No, I left Cebu.
Your land.
Cebu.
Cebu lah.
Oh, I left Cavite.
Lagi mo mang iniwan yun ah.
Ako, probably.
Maraming iniwan to eh.
School siguro. Although I took music then when I was in college, pero hindi ko na siya natapos. But yeah, I guess that's one of the biggest things.
wala pa at silent.
Oh, malinis kasi ito eh. Kasi bata pa kasi ito. He doesn't drink and smoke yet, but
yes,
you will soon. No. We're not trying to be bad influences, but you know, ano, madami kasing nag-ano sa kanya ng mga
bad friends.
Ako, I think drunk and stoned, got really stoned. It was a happy gig.
You know, happy
you know,
siya,
you know what happened?
Luckily, I got to be a part of Pyuntang Wi-Fi for quite a number of times. So yun, lagi. I can't forget this one gig na tumutugtog ako sa sigap ng Urbandub. Papainumin kami habang tumutugtog. So wala kang magagawa. Yun, mga ganun. Masaya. Maraming ganun experience.
There were a lot of times in back in the days where we almost got into a fight just because of his alcohol intake. He used to be so fucked up, man, before a gig. There was one time, remember? There were four of us in the band, so he's really drunk. So the three of us, the bass player and the drummer, we knew what to play next. So the drummer started counting. We played the same songs, the three of us, but he played a different song. Like halfway through it, but he didn't even know who was playing it. But, if you guys want to contact the band or know our schedule, gig schedules, you could find us on Facebook. Tapos yung mga tao in general who are still supporting OPM, salamat talaga for, you know, believing in your local artists, and hopefully you guys will continue to do so. You know, that would encourage us to write a lot more music and better music.
If you want to watch Franco, Urbandub, or any of the other great acts here in town, be sure to swing by their live shows and show your support. Now, to help you figure out which shows you can catch, check out the lineup in this month's Gig Blast. To the bands and artists that make the kind of music that we love. But for today's episode, we actually want to put the spotlight somewhere else. Now, every major band would be paralyzed if it wasn't for the great crew and team that helped them with every show. And the Roadies are one of the most key members of that team. While they help out and travel with their bands, these Roadies also experience some great stories of their own. And today, we wanted to share them with you on our brand new segment, Roadie Time!
Ang pala si Lord, Roadie, saka RM ng Urbandub, saka Keso.
Kutumot!
Hi, what's up? Ako nga pala si Giovanni Jordan Capote, drum tech ng Franco at Urbandub. Sabi nga nila, madali lang daw yung pagkakat crew, di ba? Hindi, mahirap talaga. Hindi siya, para sa mga crew, hindi naman sa ano ah. Mahirap talaga sa bilang isang crew.
Mas nahasa pa kami lalo nung sumama kami. Yung isang malaking tour dito sa Pilipinas, nung nasama kami doon. So nakasalumuhan namin yung mga crew ng Kamikazee, ng Parokya, ng Wolfgang. Ang Parokya sa Kamikazee, sobrang tatanda na ng crew nila. Hindi pala. Sobrang matagal na pala sila nagro-roadie.
Patay kayo. So, wala na. Na-record na yun.
So ano, makakuha ka rin sa kanila ng ano, ng tips.
Ako talaga.
Paano sila nagtatrabaho ng pro sa stage.
Oh.
Para sa akin, sila yung tinitignan ko na ano.
Ako din.
Na mga seniority na roadie.
Oh, pero ako natuto ko sa drum tips. Kasiyan diyan tsaka sa internet din. Nag-search ako ng search.
Ano
pangalan search? Ito? Pa-search sa internet ako. Anong pangalan nito? Paano mag-set up? Ni-search ko din. Kaya kung gusto niyo mag
research.
Research. Gusto niyo matuto. Note lang kayo sa internet. Nandoon din 'yon tsaka pakinggan niyo tapos
ay sinasabi nila pag roadie ka marami kang chicks, hindi totoo yun. May isang scenario din, bandang Visayas yun, sa Franco naman to, tumutugtog sila, si 8 na putulan ng strap ng gitara. So syempre, ang tendency, bawal maputol yung tugtog, diba? So sinalo ko yung gitara, nasa likod ako ni 8, hawak ako yung gitara niya, nakaganyan. Kung paano, gano'ng kababa yung gitara niya sa strap niya,
adjust mo.
D
hindi, hawak ko yung gitara, nakaganon lang ako. Nasa likod ako ni Ate habang tumutugtog, hawak ko yung gitara. So, pagtaas ng gig, palakpakan yung tao, hindi sa banda sa akin, ang galing ko daw.
Minsan din mag-aaway kami sa tunog. Wait, pangyuna, hindi mo na nun. Hindi kasi kami lang mag-aaway nito, kami lang kami yung close nito eh. Kami apat, meron din kami katangahan konti. Hindi naman natin maiwasan yun eh.
Pero mas madalas siya.
Sino?
Ikaw.
Gago ka!
Yung unang leg na nakalimutan, bandang anin eh. Bandang Bicol region. Si Jan, hindi na ako. Tumalon, nag-crowd, tumalon sa tao. So syempre, ikaw, roadie ka, hindi mo pwedeng pabayaan lang siya doon dahil alam mo mangyayari sa'yo, dadumugin ng fans. Nung tumalon siya, may sumalo sa kanya. Nung tumalon ako, wala sumalo sa akin, dire-direcho side. So parang, wow, well, di ba? Tapos si Jan, hindi na ako, binubuhat ng tao, pabalik na sa harang.
Nawala pa yung
ako, hindi inaharang nila ako, hindi ako makasampa. Binuhat ako ng mga bouncer, inangat nila ako, dahil hindi ako makasampa doon sa railing, galang mataas.
In the music scene. But for now, we have to go. Do not forget to leave your comments and suggestions below so that we know what to put on the next episode. I have to go. This has been Joyce Pring for the React. This is our fun.